it like this. Close. I like being close to you, Pete. It's nice. It's safe. I like this close. This right now, this close. You know, tonight, I think I'm about as close as I can possibly get.
Well, not really.
What?
Not really. I mean, if you think about it in a different way, you're not really close to me at all. In fact, you're about as far away from me as you could possibly be. I mean, if you think about it, technically, if you're assuming the world is round, like a ball, like a snowball, then the furthest away you can be from someone is if you're sitting right next to them. See, if I'm here, and you're here, then that's far.
Yeah.
But now you're closer. And closer. And closer. And closer. And closer. And closer. And closer!
To go to bed. I saw you from my window. Can I? Is there something I can do for you?
Oh no, I'm just here to do the lines.
Okay, it's just that. Well, you're in my yard.
I hope you don't mind. I'll open you tonight. See the northern lights, and then I'll be gone. I hope you don't mind.
Is that a tent?
Yeah.
You pitched a tent.
So I have a place.
In my yard.
I see them. I hope you don't mind.
Well, I don't mind. It's just...
Oh, no. Do you mind?
Well, I don't mind.
Oh, no. I think you do.
No, I don't mind.
Oh, no. You do. You do. I didn't think you would. I didn't think... You see, it says in your brochure that people from Maine are kind. It says that people from Maine live life the way life should be. And that in the tradition of the Brotherhood and Northern Climes, like Scandinavia, that the letter comes to who's where they need to be, in the yard for nothing. Stranger, like a cross-country skier by her height. Is it true? I'm not sure. Would you let it...
they really, really needed to, sure, but...
Oh my gosh, then thank you! Oh, I need that.
Oh, here.
Thank you.
So, you're just looking for a place to see the Northern Lights from?
Yeah.
Well, you might not see them tonight, because you never really know when they're going to show up.
Oh no, I'll see them, because we're in a good place. The latitude is good, and solar activity is at an 11-year peak. Everything's in order. And boy, you have a sky for it.
Used to be a potato farm.
Gonna say, no trees in the way? So, you're a farmer?
Oh no, used to be a farm. I'm a repairman.
Oh.
Fix things.
Oh.
What?
You're not a lobster man?
No.
Oh.
The ocean is a couple hundred miles away. It'd be an awful long ride to work if I was a lobster man.
Yeah. Well, anyway, thanks for letting me stay here. Have a bad enough time with it with not being your brother.
Oh. Oh boy. I'm sorry. I just. Well, I think I love you.
Really?
Yeah. I saw you from my window, and I love you.
Well, that's very kind of you, but there's something I think you should know. I'm not here for that.
Oh no, I didn't think you were.
I'm here to pay my respects to my husband.
Oh.
My husband, Wes. He died recently. On Tuesday, actually. And did you know this? The Northern Lights are really the torches that the recently departed carry with them on the way to heaven. And you see, it takes 3 days for a soul to make its way home to heaven. And this is Friday, the third day. So you see, I will see them, the Northern Lights, because they're him. So we came with the torches. And I didn't leave things well with him, so I was just hoping that I could come here and not be bothered. But what you did there just a second ago, that bothered me, I think, and I'm not here for that, so maybe I should just go in front of the other.
No, wait, please stay. I don't know what happened.
Well, I do. I know what happened.
I'm not the kind of person who does things like that. Just please, don't go. I won't bother you anymore. You can see the Northern Lights. Just consider what I just did to be a very warm Maine welcome.
All right. My name's Glory.
I'm East.
Huh?
For Easton. There's a mix-up on the birth certificate. A son, Easton, born on the 6th day of January, 1992, in the town of Matthew, Maine, instead of the other way around.
I'm sorry. So, Easton. Yeah, I'm Easton near there on my way here, and by the way, where am I?
Almost.
What?
You're in unorganized territory. Township 13, Range 7. It's not going to be on your map, because it's not an actual town, technically.
What do you mean?
But to be a town, you gotta get organized, and
you back, and that just killed him.
Oh, well, it didn't kill him. You didn't kill him.
Yes, I did, because he got so sad that my new heart didn't want him back that he just tore out of the hospital, and an ambulance that was coming in from an emergency didn't see him and just took him out. And if I couldn't take him back, he wouldn't have come out there like that and just been taken out. Like, please don't do that anymore.
Why? I love you.
Well, don't. I have a heart that can pump my blood, and that's it. The one that does the other stuff is broken.
Please let me have this.
My heart!
Yes, and it's broken. It's no good like this.
I don't know if I want you to fix it.
Lori, please.
My heart.
Yes, and I believe I have it. And I can fix it. I'm a repairman. It's what I do.
Oh. Oh, wow. Oh, they're so beautiful. Oh, I'm so sorry, Wes. I'm sorry. Goodbye. Hello, East.
Those people.
serious.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I do Thanksgiving and Christmas. Some of the guys who work for me, like, East, he helps me prepare sometimes. I let him stay with their family since I'm all alone this year.
Oh.
Yeah, I really don't have anybody anymore. My brother and sister are canned, so they left town.
Right.
Mom and dad both retired, heading south.
Huh.
Vermont. Yeah, it makes me easier there, they say. Oh, and I don't know if you heard this, but I spot him and died on
the Oh, gee, I didn't know that.
Yeah, he was old, it was his time. He was a good fish, though. Anyway, like I said, I really don't have any time, so I was wondering, do you want to come on over?
I
forgot to tell you, it's Friday night special at the Moose Patty. Drink free, be sad. So if you're sad, or if you two little lovebirds are ready for another couple of beds or something, just let me know, alright?
No,
sure.
Not so. Okay.
Okay!
So what do you say? Wanna come on over?
Jimmy, I can't. I really gotta get back with the
girls. No.
Yeah, Jimmy, yeah. I gotta, cause see, oh gosh, I've been telling this for a while, but there's a guy, Jimmy. I've got a guy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Glad you're getting yourself out there again. Moving on.
Actually, Jimmy, see, this is more than me just getting myself out there and moving on. This is my bachelorette party. I'm getting married.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I thought you said you weren't going to do that. Get married? I thought you said it wasn't for you. You told me. I guess it just wasn't for you with me. So who's the lucky guy?
Mark LaFaria, you know,
the Ranger.
Yeah.
He's a legend. Legendary. I mean, if you're lost out in the mountain in Maine, he's the guy we're looking for you.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're lost out here in this big, bad northern world of Maine, Mark LaFaria is the guy we're looking for you.
Yeah.
He found you.
I'm sorry I never told you. I actually thought you would have known. I thought you would have heard.
How would I have heard?
Well, you know, people talk.
Not about things that know you don't want to hear they don't. And I gotta be honest with you, that's not something I would have wanted. So when's the big event?
Tomorrow.
Really?
Yep.
Well then.
Hey!
What are you doing?
On our waitress. She said holler. What's her name?
I don't know. She's new here.
Hey!
What are you doing?
We gotta celebrate. You got found. And you deserve it. He's quite a guy.
Oh, Jimmy.
And so are you.
Jimmy.
Hey!
Whoa. Hey, what's that?
What?
That.
Oh, nothing. Tattoo. Hey!
Wait, when'd you get that?
After you left. Hey!
Wait.
Come on.
What's it? Villian?
Villain.
Who's Villian?
Villain. It's supposed to say villain.
What?
It's supposed to say villain.
Well, it doesn't say villain. It says Villian.
I know I spelled it wrong.
What?
They spelled it wrong. It says Villian, but it's supposed to say villain.
Well, why does it say villain? Why would you want to tattoo that says villain?
Cause
why?
Just cause why? Just cause. When a guy's got a girl like you, when a guy like me loses a girl like you, when a guy like me drives a girl like
Jimmy,
you away,
you didn't drive me away.
It's criminal. It's plain criminal. It's villainy. So I marked myself so girls would stay away from me. So I'd never have to go through what I went through with you again. Can I kiss
no.
you?
No! You can get that undone, you know.
Yeah.
I got ahead.
Yeah. Hey. I'm glad you got found.
Thanks, Jimmy.
Sorry. You laid me down. There's this bachelorette party up front. Those girls. Good thing it's not drink free if you're glad. Because those girls are really glad. Oh gosh, I had to find my way to find you. But I did it. I found you. So what can you do for? Another couple of beds or something?
No, thank you.
Oh gosh. Oh gee, pal. Remember, like I said, drink free if you're sad. So just say the word, tell me that you're sad and don't drink free, alright? Tell me if I'm sad and you're looking pretty sad. Alright, well, if you need anything, I'm Villian. Yes?
Hi. I'm not sad, I just would like another bud.
Okay.
Villian?
Yeah?
I'm glad you found me.
Aw, glad you found me. That's adorable.
Thank you.
smashed you with an ironing board. I wasn't even looking. Are you hurt?
No.
Oh, you must be. I just smashed you. Where did I get you?
In the head.
In the head. Oh, come here. Are you okay?
Is there any blood?
No.
Any discoloration?
No.
Then I'm okay.
What? Listen, I was gonna be a nurse, so I know. You're hurt. You're hurt. You just took a good shot right to the head. Not serious.
No, it's not serious. I don't think an ironing board could really hurt your head, because see, ironing boards are not on my list of things that can hurt you.
What?
Plus, there's no blood or discoloration from where I got hit, so.
What?
And my list is pretty reliable, because my brother Paul has helped me make it. And I can prove it to you, see? I bet. Yeah. I bet if I took this ironing board, like this, and hit you with it, that it wouldn't hurt you.
What?
Go ahead.
Ow!
Oh.
Ow, what the hell was
that?
Did
that hurt?
Yeah!
Oh, that hurt. I'm sorry. I didn't think it would, because see, ironing boards aren't on my list of things that can hurt you, but gosh, maybe they should be, because...
What are you talking about?
I have a list of things that can hurt you. My brother Paul is helping me make it, and ironing boards aren't on it.
Well, that ironing board hurt me.
Yeah.
So you should add it to your list.
Yeah. Should I be afraid of ironing boards?
Well, if someone swings it at your head and whops you with it, yes.
Well, it's not. I have a list of things to be afraid of, too, and ironing boards are not on this list either.
They shouldn't be, really.
No?
No, you shouldn't be afraid of ironing boards.
But they can hurt me.
Yes.
So I should be afraid of them.
No.
So I shouldn't be afraid of them?
Yes.
But they can hurt me.
Yes.
Oh, so they're kind of like the opposite of God, right?
What?
Ironing boards can hurt me, but I shouldn't be afraid of them. But God, my brother Paul says, God won't hurt me, but I should fear him.
I guess.
Boy, this is getting very complicated.
What is
this business of remembering what hurts, what doesn't hurt, what to be afraid of, what not to be afraid of?
Are you sure you're okay? You're just going on and on about crazy stuff.
Oh, yeah, I have congenital analgesia, he says. Some
what?
People, congenital analgesia.
Who says?
My brother Paul. Some people call it hereditary sensory neuropathy type 4, but it just means I can't feel pain.
What?
You can hit me if you want to, see?
No.
It won't hurt, see?
Ow!
See?
Ow!
See?
Ow!
Go ahead.
No!
Go ahead.
No!
Come on!
No!
Come on.
No!
Okay. You don't hit me. Most people don't hit me. Most people just go away. You can go away too if you want to. That's what people do when I tell them about myself. My brother Paul says I just shouldn't tell people about myself because I scare them, so I've actually recently put myself on my list of things.
But are you okay?
Yeah, I don't feel pain.
Don't feel pain, right? Of course you're okay, but are you sure?
Is there any blood?
No.
Any discoloration?
No.
Then I'm okay.
Well, buddy, you can be hurt and I didn't look like it.
But
trust me, there are things that hurt you that don't make you bruised and bloody, and there are things that hurt you that make you bruised and bloody, and they all hurt. I'm Marvin.
I'm Steve, third floor, room 11.
Yeah, I live with my boyfriend, Eric. I love him very much.
Yeah, we saw you move in.
Yeah, our roof collapsed from all the snow in December. We're just here until we can get our feet back on the ground.
Oh, well, that's good, because that's what Ma Dudley says her boarding house is. A place where people can go to get their feet back on the ground. My brother Paul says we've been trying to get our feet back on the ground our whole lives.
Oh.
Yeah, he says it takes some people longer to do that than others.
Yeah.
You guys are loud.
Huh?
You and Eric, you yell and bang. We're right below you.
Oh, sorry about that. We're going through a rough patch. Happened, sorry. What is it like?
What?
To not feel pain.
I don't know. I don't really know what it's like to hurt, so I don't know. I don't really feel.
Is this how you were born?
Yeah, I don't have fully developed pain sensors, he says, and they're immature. And because they're immature, my development as a human being has been retarded, he says. He reads.
What? What do you mean?
He teaches me what hurts.
But why?
So I won't ruin myself. I have to know when to be afraid, because my body doesn't know what being hurt is. And I have to memorize what to be afraid of, too. Things like bears and guns and knives and fire and fear! I should fear fear itself and pretty girls.
Pretty girls?
Yeah.
Why should you be afraid of pretty girls?
Because my brother Paul says they can hurt you because they make you love them.
What?
And that's something I'm supposed to be afraid of too, love, but my brother Paul says I'm really lucky because I'll probably never have to deal with love because I have a lot of deficiencies and not very many capacities as a result of the congenital analgesia.
Wait, what do you mean? You're never going to have to deal with love.
I'm never going to know what it feels like.
Well, why?
Because it hurts.
It shouldn't.
Plus, I have a lot of deficiencies and not very many capacities.
You know what? A lot of people do. Oh no, I am so sorry. I don't know what I was thinking. Oh my god. Are you okay? I'm so sorry. Are you okay? Are you alright?
Is there any blood?
No.
Any discoloration?
No.
Then I'm alright.
Yeah. Sorry about that. It's just, you're just very sweet.
But you have a boyfriend and you love him very much.
Yes, I do, and yes.
And you just kissed me.
Yes, I did.
And it's a Friday night, and you're doing the laundry.
Yes, I am.
And people who are in love with each other, they don't kiss other people and do their laundry on Friday nights. I've learned that. People who are in love with each other, they go to the moose patty on Friday nights, or they go dancing together, or they go skating, and they kiss each other. They don't kiss other people. You know what? I don't think that's love, what you and your boyfriend have.
You know what? I've been down here longer than I said I'd be, and he doesn't like that.
Who?
My boyfriend.
You love very much.
Yes.
Even though you kiss me?
Yes.
Well, I'm gonna have to talk to my brother Paul about this.
No, don't talk to your brother Paul about this. What? Tell him to stop teaching you.
But
whatever he's teaching you, tell him to stop. What he's teaching you isn't something you'll know.
But I have to learn from him.
Look, I was gonna be a nurse, so I know. You need to go to a doctor and not have your brother read whatever it is he reads. I gotta go.
Right. You gotta go. You're leaving. I know you would. That's what people do.
No, I just told you, Eric doesn't like it.
Your boyfriend?
Yeah, he doesn't like it if I'm down here longer than I said I'd be. And I've been down here longer than I said I'd be. Oh no, Ow. I'm so sorry, are you? Ow. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I just did that to you again!
Ow.
Oh my god, are you? Wait, what did you just say?
Ow.
Thank you.
can't very well grind getting your love, because that's all I have right now. It's the love you gave me. I can't very well grind getting your love to other guys.
Other guys?
Right.
There are other guys.
No, not yet, but I'm assuming there will be.
Kale, please.
And so I think now that I know you're not ready to do what comes next for people who have been together for quite a long time, I think we're going to be done. And so the next best thing we can do now is just return the love we gave each other and call it even. Oh, geez, my girl, is this really all the love I gave you, Lentil? I mean, what kind of person am I if this is all I gave you? No. No. I know I gave you more than this, Lentil. I know it.
No, Kale!
Did you lose it, Lentil? Because I know I gave you more than this. And I think maybe you're pulling something on me, and this is not a good time to be pulling something on me.
I'm not pulling something on you. I think... Gosh. Some of the basement. I actually